On behalf of Mandir GK and PrepQ, I welcome you to this session of current affairs. And as always, I will again discuss with you a few exam-oriented questions, questions that might appear in some of the government exams or that might appear in some of the MBA entrance exams. Here is the first question. And before that, the date today is 16th July 2019. And here is your first question. Who has won the men's singles title in Wimbledon 2019? So this year, the men's singles Wimbledon title was won by Novak Djokovic. Yesterday only I told you that women's title was won by Simona Halep from Romania. And now the men's single has been won by Novak Djokovic. He defeated Roger Federer in the final in perhaps the longest Wimbledon final ever. It was a 5-set match which continued to 4 hours and 57 minutes approximately. So this match was, this title was Djokovic's 16th Grand Slam title and probably the 6th Wimbledon title, mind you. Next question. On what basis did England win the Cricket World Cup final match against New Zealand? So the day before yesterday, there were two great finals played, one between Djokovic and Roger Federer, that is in tennis, Wimbledon, and the second between England and New Zealand, which was the Cricket World Cup final. And both these matches had a big fight before any result could follow. In case of cricket, it was England who won the Cricket World Cup final, and they won by the more number of boundaries scored by England during the match. So the runs scored during the 50 over match by both England and New Zealand happened to be 241. Then both of them played one super over. Again, they were tied at 15 runs apiece. And thereafter, the winner was declared by the number of boundaries that were scored by the team. In this case, England scored more number of boundaries and therefore won the match. Next question. When is Chandrayaan 2 expected to touch the lunar surface? So, the first thing that you should know is Chandrayaan 2 was launched on 15th July, that is yesterday only. And after its launch, it is expected to touch the lunar surface near the south pole of the moon on September 6, 2019. So Chandrayaan 2 is India's second lunar probe and its first attempt to make a soft landing on moon. So it has an orbiter, and what does the orbiter do? Orbiter will actually go around the moon for an year in an orbit of 100 km from the surface, and a lander and a rover. Both the lander and rover are expected to be active for 1 month. The orbiter, the lander and rover are each fitted with several instruments to carry out experiments. So that is about the parts of Chandrayaan. Rover is basically a six-wheel robotic vehicle named Pragyan. It can travel up to 500 meters and will leverage solar energy for this purpose. Lander is named the Vikram Lander. And orbiter is capable of communicating with Indian deep satellite network near Bengaluru. How is Chandrayaan 2 different from Chandrayaan 1? So Chandrayaan 2, through this particular mission, ISRO is trying to land on some extraterrestrial surface for the first time. In fact, in Chandrayaan 1, the moon impact probe had actually made a landing, but it was a crash landing, and therefore the moon impact probe was totally destroyed in the process of landing. In Chandrayaan 2, by contrast, the vehicle will have a soft landing. And how is this soft landing achieved? Because moon is not expected to have an atmosphere, and therefore parachute like objects may not achieve the soft landing. So in case of moon, the vehicles are going to use technologies to slow down the lander, and in this case the lander will be slowed down by thrusters which will be fired in opposite direction to slow the landing of the lander. So one unique thing about this particular mission is it is attempting, Chandrayaan 2 is attempting to land on the south pole of the moon. So there have been 28 landings on the moon so far, including 6 human landings. All these landings have taken place in equatorial region, and it is for the first time that a vehicle is trying to attempt to land in the near the south pole of moon. So Chandrayaan 2 will carry out extensive three-dimensional mapping of the topography of the lunar surface, and will also determine its elemental composition and seismic activity. Next question. Where is India's first elephant rehabilitation center proposed to be launched? So it is proposed in Kothur. So this rehabilitation center is coming up at a cost of ₹105 crore. It comprises an elephant museum, mahout training center, a super specialty hospital for elephants, a retirement home for injured elephants, and a crematorium for animals. And it is created on the lines of Pinnawala Elephant Orphanage in Sri Lanka. Next, which Indian city will host the Women's Startup Summit on August 1, 2019? The correct answer is Kochi. The Startup Summit seeks to promote women entrepreneurship in a big way. So Kerala Startup Mission, KSUM Kusum, it is hosting this particular summit in association with Indian Women Network, floated by Confederation of Indian Industries at the Integrated Startup Complex, Kochi. So this Women's Startup Summit 2019 aims at encouraging aspiring women professionals to take up their entrepreneurial journey. Next question. Who was named as the Men's Footballer of the Year 2019 at the All India Football Federation Awards? Now the only name that comes to mind is Sunil Chhetri in this case. Next question. M.J. Radhakrishnan, who passed away recently, was associated with which of the following? So he was associated with Malayalam films in particular. Next question. With whom has Bharat Chamber of Commerce signed an MOU for promoting trade and investments? The correct answer is BRICS. Now what does BRICS stands for? BRICS stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, which form the BRICS group. SAFTA is nothing but South African Free Trade Area, and ASEAN stands for Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Next question. To what percent has India's child mortality reduced as per the Multidimensional Poverty Index 2019? The correct answer is 2.2. So the Global Multidimensional Poverty Index was developed in 2010. And who developed it? Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative, along with United Nations Development Program. These were the two institutions behind Global Multidimensional Poverty Index. They use various factors to determine poverty beyond income-based poverty. And this Global Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI, actually has replaced the previously used Human Poverty Index. So MPI, the Multidimensional Poverty Index, is an international measure of acute poverty covering over 100 developing countries. So that is about the Multidimensional Poverty Index. Next question. Which High Court has recently asked lawyers to not use the term my lord or lordship while addressing the judges of this court? So this was done by the Rajasthan High Court. Although the Bar Council of India had taken such a decision in 2006, but still the lawyers and advocates refer to the judges as my lord or lordship. So recently, Rajasthan High Court actually suggested not to use these terms as they were reminiscent of the colonial era. Next, so with this we reach the question of the day. The first question is, on what basis did England win the Cricket World Cup final match against New Zealand in 2019? And the second question, with whom has Bharat Chamber of Commerce signed an MOU for promoting trade and investments? So if you know the answers to these questions, please write them in the comment section given below. CAT aspirants can log on to myprepq.com for 3 wonderful CAT courses. For career related advice, please contact me on this number through WhatsApp. That's all for now. Thank you very much.